streaming. This is Manolis. He's been working on porting Guix to Hurd. So thank you for showing up.
Hello, everyone. I would like in this talk to show you the work I have done in the last 3 years in porting Guix to GNU Hurd and hopefully GuixSD soon enough. But before I start on the specifics of the port, I would like to first explain what bootstrapping is. Jan here said some things about bootstrapping, but I would like to get a bit more on. I would get to say more details about the Guix specific of bootstrapping. As I say in my slide here, simply speaking, bootstrapping refers to the process of getting the distribution built from nothing. But the question is, how do you build the first package? In most distros, you just use what's already there. Whatever there's already in that maintainer's computer, whatever compiler, whatever glibc, that's it. You're gonna use it, but the thing is that you may end up in a system that if somebody tries to bootstrap it in any other way outside of that system, it will not work. Like for example, I will say something else first. And this makes things hard to track down. Now Guix comes in. And I want to explain how Guix does it. Every system, or every GNU system, has libc at its core. Also, the GNU build system needs core utils, awk, find utils, a bound bus, and everything. And in Guix, we also need the guile, because we use it to run configure, make install, and everything. The process is complete when you have a full tool chain, on Guix at least, that at the end it will not refer to the final to the bootstrap binaries. That's why Guix has three levels of compilers. We first start with the bootstrap binaries, then we create an intermediate compiler which only uses the bootstrap bus, and then we end up with a glibc final, a GCC final that doesn't need the bootstrap binary. You just remove them, and that's it. So Jan showed it before as well, and I would like to get into more detail on this. And how? Yes, I would like to explain. So what happens here? We first start with bootstrap guile. With the derivation of bootstrap guile. We use the in every system. Whenever you start, you have the bootstrap GCC, bootstrap glibc, bootstrap static utils, and bootstrap bin utils and bootstrap guile. And also you need to have tar, xz, make dir, and bus. You use them to decompress the guile tarball, and then by slowly building the derivations with guile, you end up into decompressing glibc, GCC, and everything, and then up with the bootstrap toolchain. Okay, and after that, this starts. how many of you have actually read about the Guix bootstrap procedure? Except you. Yes, the maintainer. Okay. So it isn't so complex as it seems. It just took me 2 years to understand it. This is the second stage. We have all the bootstrap toolchain, and then we slowly build our way up to get to the glibc intermediate, and then continue using that intermediate glibc to get the final glibc. This is for Linux. For Linux, exactly that. Pretty simple, working, and everything. Okay. So, what's the procedure to port it to a new platform? Like for ARM, for ARM 32 bits, or I would say ARM 64. Is a frame here? I don't see him. For 32 bit ARM, for example, it's pretty simple. You build the bootstrap tables. You inject those bootstrap binaries to the directed graph, and you clone Guix on that platform, and you start building it. That's it. That's pretty on Linux 32 bit and 64. This is it. Not on Hurd. It wasn't that simple. The Hurd has a very different architecture. You have a microkernel called GNU Mach on the base, and then over GNU Mach you run the Hurd servers. The Hurd servers implement most of the things that for example Linux does in the kernel space. So so in order to work around the thing that the kernel doesn't offer the same services, and it offers them the head servers offer them, glibc offers some interfaces that abstract these strange and different interfaces and everything. So directly it makes things will not work, nobody guarantees that by glibc interfaces the things will work the same way. Maybe some apps, for example, accept some interfaces from proc to be exported from the kernel, which doesn't happen. So here's how you bootstrap Hurd on a Hurd system. One last thing. In order to do the first step, you don't only to build the bootstrap tables for the new platform, you first have to build the toolchain, the cross compilers for that platform, which on its own it's a really big effort, because Guix, for example, had some expected only to design with Linux in mind. I will show you some code later so you can see it with your own eyes. So in here, you can see that the Hurd has some, I would say, dependencies, SQL dependencies that you have to eliminate. For example, I want you to see the Hurd headers here, the glibc headers there, the Hurd minimal head minimal over there, and the Hurd kernel headers. This is wrong. It should be Hurd core headers. I just used my graph from last year and forgot to change that. It's a package that includes all the headers that you need, and then the glibc library and the glibc compiler. So, in order to build glibc, you need libhash from the Hurd. But in order to build the Hurd libraries, you need the glibc. So you can see that why it can get hard to, and why you should never have SQL dependencies, like npm, for example, like I learned yesterday. I don't use JavaScript. I avoid it. So some of the problems that you can find. There are simple problems like pathmax, but it's pretty easy to fix. And really hard problems like binaries for i686 GNU target will not run on the Hurd system. Actually, at least when I tried to run them 2 years ago, they wouldn't. Justus remembers that when we had this issue, but there was something with the glibc, I don't know. I found that the i586 version worked, so I prefer to use that way. We had, as I said before, Guix, when it was designed, had only Linux in mind, so I had to change Guix to take into account both kernels, like to teach Guix to be kernel agnostic. It shouldn't care about what kernel you run. Actually, I remember reading in the Hurd manual that supposedly a long time ago, you were able to remove the Linux kernel add the GNU kernel and the head libraries, and it would work. Supposedly it should have, like many years ago. I don't know what happened. And many things like Debian-specific package, Debian-specific patches in glibc that were not present in glibc. Parts of some long-forgotten patches that nobody had. This is not because that the head developers do not try or do not care. They are really awesome guys, awesome engineers. They know what they're doing. They just need more contributors. Because the Hurd is a little, people laugh with the Hurd, but it's a really nice project. It's a really something that people should really spend more time and try to help, because it can really make you learn new things. And I will leave it to your. And at this time, after this happened at 2 years. After I finished my GSOC in 2015, I think, yes, we were at the level that you could run this command in Guix. We had an error and would. Yes, I'm starting to get a bit nervous, so. So this was the work of 2 years.
Live demo time.
Okay, my laptop is a bit slow, so, but we have time. Yes, we have time.
It's taken 2 years, so we can wait for.
Yeah, 5 minutes now.
Yeah!
Whoa!
What's that doing? You're running the garbage collector?
It's to the dependencies of the package, so you can see. Yeah, this is it.
Ah, okay.
So. This is what you need to boot Guix on a new system. This is the binaries. That's it. So when we got this, we have to get to the new platform. As I said before, in any Linux system, you update the GNU package bootstrap module. You tell GNU system am where to download the files and everything. You clone Guix, you run configure. This with courage here, this option here. it's to tell Guix that you don't support the platform yet, but you have the courage to do it. And you begin building everything. Begin building the world. Nowadays, it works. We still have some issues with packages that need patches. Like, for example, GOC has a patch that fails. Guile needs a patch on how to handle time on the Hurd, because, and I need to tackle this. There are a lot of packages that have really simple errors, like simple test errors. It's all test errors. Something that maybe somewhere doesn't work correctly on the Hurd. It doesn't need to be fixed, but let's say that any one of you wants to try Guix on Hurd. You just go clone core updates branch, run Guix on your Linux machine, build the bootstrap binaries, because for now we haven't still yet added it to the actual master branch. But they're available on Hydra, so you can download them from there. This is exactly what you need to do to run Guix on a Hurd. This is it. It's not more complicated than that. Okay, I'll get in a second there. So at that moment, currently on a Hurd, it's really these patches and everything. But there's still something that I need to work on the Hurd. It's the daemon. And the tools that I need to create the GuixSD image. For example, Guix uses some syscall some syscalls from like mount, umount, pivot root, in order to create the image, and all of these to create the GuixSD image, and all of these syscalls do not exist on the Hurd. There's a completely different architecture. It's what I told you before. Where was it? Well, yes. We have some DLibC offers some interfaces. We have on the Hurd they have a util called mount that can do the same thing, but it's not mount. It uses a very different way to achieve it with translators. I suggest you, there's a very nice paper that explains what translators is on the Hurd. I don't remember the name exactly, it's on the Hurd wiki. Okay. So, what I did during the last GSOC is write some wrappers using, actually first, I said there's a util in Hurd called the set trans, which you can use to set translators. So in order to make my life easier and anybody else in the future, I created a libhurd util library, which is still somewhere in the mailing list that I need to someday finish, that offers a procedure called set runs. You can just call it, you can just pass some arguments, and you can create whatever translator you want without actually accessing the insides of the Hurd and everything. Like, it's like an easy interface to create these translators. And then
another 10 minutes.
Come on, not again. So I use the set runs to create a wrapper for mount, and so Guix, and I call and I for and the daemon now, and I change all the usage of mount on the Guix daemon with Nix mount. I called it Nix because the director inside the that we keep the daemon in the source, it's still called Nix because we use to share the same daemon. Nowadays it's way different. But just for I will change it when the time comes, the name. So I'm using Nix mount, and the daemon actually thinks that it uses normal mount syscall, but it actually uses the wrapper that hides everything. For the MS bind option that we need, I use framelinks, and this last one is not still ready, but someone suggested that there isn't something like pivot root for the Hurd, and pivot root it's not ch root. It actually changes the way that the application sees its root directory. Someone suggested to use fake root. This is still in work. This is not finished, but this may not end up like that. So. Now on the GuixSD front, why I haven't finished GuixSD yet, which many people are asking me. Let's say that you want to run this command, okay? If you try to cross build GuixSD image for the Hurd through from Linux, you will not be able to do it because of the way that the daemon creates the derivation of the system creates the binaries. It actually expects to build and run the binaries of that target on the system you are building it. This has to change in the future to actually use the cross build binaries to create the image from another image. There is a hack that you can do to work around it, like you can have an offload machine, but it's a hack. You can have a hack machine. I prefer to find the correct solution. There's still some things in some modules of Guix that they were designed with Linux in mind. So let's say that you say the same command. You want to run but from the Hurd this time, and you want to run to build GuixSD. It first assumes that you run Linux. That you have a RAM disk, which you don't. on the heritage, much different. And still, there are still other problems with, that don't have anything to do with Guix. Even Justus told me that there's some special attributes that the EXT25 system should have on the Hurd. Justus has the solution and works. Anyhow. Because I'm starting to lose the way of my thought. Guys, if you really want to help with the port, just try to run Guix on any demo head machine for now, and try to build packages. There's a guy called René Saev. I'm not sure about the. I will mispronounce the surname. I will not say. His name is René, and he's really doing exactly that. He's trying to build anything on the head packages, and he's always sending packages to Guix, and tries to fix that. All the bit failures, like a test failing, he will find why and he will, or at least report it. Or even at least report the issues so I can know whatever happens. So I can slowly get there. It's a lot of work. It's not difficult work. I would call it grunt work. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, so the current status, you can cross build everything. Like, let's say, build core utils. Actually, you will not be able to see anything, so. Yes, better this way. It's this simple. Right now you can cross build anything from Linux, except GuixSD, every package from Linux to the Hurd by using this. Guix build target, the name of the package. If it doesn't have to do with the GuixSD, it can be built. I have already 50 packages in Guix, 50 patches in Guix head related. I should have written core utils here. I wrote the talk a week ago, so I forgot that. The Guix daemon as I told you before. Ah, and Ludo last week started the cross compilation job on Hydra. So, if you want to build anything on for the Hurd from Guix, you will not have to bend your machine. You can just download the binaries. So, work in progress. Finish the lib Hurd util library. This is the. The wrapper library I'm using on Nick on the daemon to mask a mount and everything. Continue making Guix kernel agnostic. And package the Hurd libraries because I have still not packaged the actual Hurd libraries. I have only packaged, what I needed, like libihash. It's the only thing that I needed in order to. It was the Hurd libihash. The GNU mach kernel. It's also somewhere in the mailing list, the package waiting. there was a small thing that I had to change and I didn't have the time to do. Anyhow, the roadmap. Finish GuixSD, Linux seems missing dependencies, and hopefully I will someday make use of Justus' work on Sephertz. If you haven't seen his talk yesterday on the microkernel dev room, please do. That's it. I would like to thank everyone that from Guix Hurd. Special thanks to René. He's really helpful. Everyone from FSF, because this work was from GSOC. So I was working two continuous summers on GSOC. It was really nice. I became part of the community, which was my target. I wanted to be part of this community. So thank you guys, everyone. That's it. Any questions?
So who is using the Hurd?
So Shoto is making fun of the Hurd again. I can see like a couple of guys here using the Hurd, and I. Who's using the Hurd in here?
I do.
One, two, three, four. There.
Very good.
I never said that when it was created, yes, Hurd was supposed to be the replacement for the Unix kernel, but that didn't happen. But still, the Hurd, unless you want some, nobody told you to use it as an everyday system. But it's a nice system to hack on and learn things. So don't stay at that. The Hurd is not released. The Hurd is not ready. The Hurd is ready. The Hurd can be used. It depends on what you want to use it for. If you want to play games, yes, of course, the Hurd cannot play games. But if you want to hack a bit and learn things, you should use it. Give it a try. There's nothing. You just launch a VM, Debian Hurd VM. That's it. And you you don't have to do anything crazy to run it. And especially with the Debian Hurd installer, it's pretty simple. I even run it on bare metal hardware as well, just for the fun of it. Anyhow, any questions? No? Ah, yes.
Excuse me, because I haven't actually tried it. But from what I understand, Hurd has been using, or has been experimenting with using the ROM microkernel to use some device driver stuff.
Excuse me, can you repeat that? Can you say it louder? Because I...
I read somewhere that Hurd has been experimenting with the ROM microkernel.
Yes, and I'm not the one suitable to answer. I think Justus will be more in position to answer about the... Justus maybe would do.
So currently we are using a lot of drivers from Linux, and that is really tricky because Linux is evolving so fast. And we are trying to use the ROM kernel, which is basically an FOSDEM,
What I'm currently doing is I'm running Guix on Debian Hurd, and I hopefully want to make GuixSD work, so I can run pure Hurd with GuixSD, like Guix based Hurd.
Okay.
I wanted to ask, are there any features which conflict with Guix? Because earlier we heard about services management, and I think that also Hurd has some services management and such things, or there are any conflicts between them?
That's an interesting question. So the question is, if there will be any conflicts with the way that Guix handles services and the Hurd? I think that only time. I'm not in position to say if it will be conflicts or not. Time will tell. We will see, and then we will work around it as we go. Maybe even in the Hurd, we'll be able to not use the Linux way of doing it, but take use of their way of doing it. We will work it as we go. I don't know. I cannot answer it with certainty.
Thank you.
Anyone more?
Am I wrong about this? I think the Shepherd manual says it's originally planned to be used for the Hurd, right? Like,
right.
So like the Shepherd, the Guix system services use is Shepherd, which was originally planned for the Hurd anyway. So like that's like a direct, like so that vision is not incompatible, I think.
Yes, it's Chris here said about the Shepherd that it was designed to be used with the Hurd, but the thing is that. Who used it for the last time? We need to test it in order to make sure that it works.
Right.
Hopefully it will. We don't know. That's why I don't want to say anything with certainty.
I think the question about possible feature conflicts is about passive translators in the Hurd, which is some form of configuration management stored in the file system directly. Mm-hmm. I think that's what you had in mind, right?
Yes, well, I don't know much of Hurd yet, but it was something related.
So, I think I will have to talk with Dust about this question and then better ask it later. So if maybe we can discuss it after the talk on my own. Okay. Anything else? Okay, that's it, I think. Thank you.